Hi, I'm Johnny from Vega4, and you're watching the 24 Hours Podcast.
T-minus 4, 3, 2, 1.
The following is a 24 Hours Podcast.
I want to talk about the makeup of the band, because you're kind of like the United Nations. You're Irish.
Yeah.
You got a Canadian. How do four guys from different?
Well, actually, there's one of the members left a few months ago, and the band is now being joined by Gavin, who's also from Ireland. So I like to think of us as an Irish band with a Canadian drummer and New Zealand guitarist.
Okay.
London was one of those places where we all kind of ended up in. I know I have to say London, UK when I'm here, don't I?
Yeah. Well, yeah, we think of London, England before we think of London, Ontario.
Oh, do you?
Oh, yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
Right. So we met in London, England, and it's just kind of one of those places. It's big. People go there when they have big ideas. And so the three of us ended up there, the three of us that are in the band now. And we met Gavin through mutual friends, and that's where we are now.
People that are quick to describe your music make references to bands like Snow Patrol and some U2. What influences did you have growing up that you bring to your music today?
I think it wasn't just influences growing up that I bring to music. You know, I can walk down the street in a place like Vancouver and want to write a song about it. That's what you do when you write songs, you know, when you're a songwriter. I don't think that musical influences are necessarily the most important ones, you see. But musically, when I was growing up, my dad had a huge Beatles record collection, and he had Irish traditional folk music like the Dubliners, the Furies, stuff like that. But you know, I could listen to a record now and it would change everything for me, absolutely everything. That's the beauty of art, you know, it's really contextual.
What about your natural inclination with, you know, the Celtic music influence and stuff in your native Ireland? Do you find there's elements of that in your music?
Only in the sense that I think maybe my voice, I sing with an Irish accent. So you can kind of hear that I'm Irish in there, but there's no panpipes or boring drums. I would be as quick to listen to Japanese music or African music or South American music as I would Irish. You know, I think there's as much to find, much juice and beauty to find in there as there is in my own.
Now, you don't sound terribly Irish. I mean, I can hear little lilts in your voice, but I mean, did you not have a thick accent to begin with, or have you kind of lost it?
Well, I'm not from the part of Ireland that you probably associate an Irish accent being like a Southern Irish accent from Dublin or Cork. I'm from the Northwest, which is a bit softer than the sort of the Irish lilt that Gavin has. You should talk to Gavin. He talks like a leprechaun. He looks a bit like one, too.
Really? Mm. Does Ireland claim you as their own now? I mean, is Vega4 considered an Irish band?
I don't think so. I think it's nice not to be specifically from anywhere. I think we're probably more seen as a British band because we're based in London. But I am definitely wholeheartedly Irish. You know, I walk around with my Irish heart on my sleeve, definitely. I love being Irish. I'm very proud of it.
Now, in this day and age, a lot of people get their tunes downloaded and stuff like that. And I know that, you know, Vega4 has certainly gained some support from that. Do you find that the internet is probably the best marketing tool for a band these days?
I'm a huge fan of the internet. I'm excited by it. I'm definitely somebody that would shout about it, and I like using it myself. I think, you know, that the idea now that we can choose and vote with our feet, you know, a website that we love, we can put a record up there, we can make it in our bedroom and put it on the internet and people can download it and buy it, and you can make a living doing that. You know, it's a pretty amazing world that we live in now, where we have access to information that much. You know, they say now that the information is the new gold, and I think it is, you know, and now we just have to find ways to get it around to people better. I love the idea of going into a coffee shop with my laptop, being able to check my email, write a blog and send it up there, like I did this morning here in Vancouver.
Mm-hmm. And what about the ability to interact with your friends via MySpace and things? I mean, that's obviously a really good way to build a solid base of fans, isn't it?
It certainly is, yeah. I mean, to be honest, the MySpace thing, we tend to take an arm's length approach to reacting to questions and such. Hiya. Only in the... that was That was the leprechaun looking one.
Kind of
the room.
As much.
That was good. He should have come in.
A black bearded leprechaun.
A black bearded leprechaun with a hat. If you hadn't looked away there, he would have given you three wishes before he left the room. But you looked away, so you lost your three wishes.
Sorry.
It's a shame.
Okay.
Yeah, the MySpace thing is really, really powerful and really important. We've got now a couple of 100,000 hits or something like that in MySpace, which is not massive by any means at all. But the nice idea is that those couple of 100,000 people have got a couple of 100,000 friends between them, and it squares and grows, and the whole thing exponentially curves. And it's an amazing idea that we can have a network of people who can talk about things they're passionate about and they love, and they can find out about you and your music and what you're doing. You know, there's a guy called, his band is called Play Radio Play, and I think he's the biggest MySpace on the internet. He had like 4 million MySpace hits or something like that. And this is before he even had a record out. And that's sort of indicative, I think, of the power of the internet. Apart from the fact he's a very, very talented kid. It was huge on MySpace before it came out at all. You know, we write songs, and those songs are not really that complicated, and they're not really that hard to get. And I think if you come to shows and you enjoy music and you want to be part of something, I don't think that you have to work very hard to get us. We're not really trying to, rewrite anything historically. I just want to play music forever, you know, and keep doing this. Mm-hmm. Being in North America and Canada is pretty special. It's huge. It's, you know, we drove more today, longer distance today, and it looks like a dot in your map than my entire country takes to drive.
Really?
You know, I mean, you drive for 3 hours and you're off. You get wet in Ireland, you know.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Yeah. Well, listen, I tell you, you've heard the accolades. It's a solid record. A lot of people are very excited about it. Nice meeting you, and best of luck to Vega4. 24hrs.ca.